It's always sad to see someone you look up to suffer. And for those of you who don't know, John Meadows is a very popular bodybuilder, and unfortunately, he recently had a heart attack. You know, I remember 5, 6, 7 years ago when I was really into bodybuilding, he was honestly one of my favorite people to watch. His grocery hauls, his weightlifting tips, and you know, I thought he knew so much about nutrition at the time. I mean, I've learned a lot more myself since. But thankfully he is still here, but many are not. 1 in 4 people die of a heart attack, and that's 25% of the population. It's insane. You know, we're locked inside for some fake nonsense, and 25% of people are dropping dead because their heart explodes. The first thing people are going to bring up is performance-enhancing drugs, but John had blockages in his heart, which happens regardless of that, and I don't think steroids would even cause heart conditions under proper nutrition and lifestyle guidelines. Plus, John had a normal-sized heart. The purpose of this discussion today is for you guys to understand 2 predominant causes of heart disease, why a bodybuilding lifestyle may promote certain aspects of heart disease, and how to prevent them. So, I made 2 videos explaining these mechanisms over the past few years on my channel. One goes over how saturated fat and cholesterol don't cause heart disease, and that the real problem is fat from omega-6 linoleic acid. The other video discusses the complicated mechanism of calcification and how our soft tissue behaves differently under certain circumstances. Since John didn't have any calcification in his heart while he was scanned, we're going to cover the issue with fat first. In John's latest video talking about his heart attack, he mentioned that one cause of heart disease was improper nutrition. You know, briefly mentioning that people think it's okay to eat a lot of egg yolks and that it might be a problem, which is technically right. First thing to understand is what omega-6 linoleic acid is. It's a polyunsaturated fat that occurs at very small percentages in the majority of foods that humans are supposed to consume. Wild quality fruits, vegetables, grains, tubers, grass-fed meats, wild caught fish, properly raised foods, farm-raised eggs, all of these have a very low percentage of linoleic acid, always below 4%, usually even like 1%. Our modern standard American diets have crazy high amounts of this linoleic acid because we're consuming unnatural foods. Vegetable seed oils in particular, nuts and seeds, are foods humans were never meant to eat in large amounts, and when you feed those foods to animals, the fat profile of the meat also becomes high in linoleic acid. It sounds crazy, but consuming factory farmed pork or chicken is comparable to consuming, you know, soybean oil, canola oil, because of the crap they're feeding the animals. Any of you guys familiar with bodybuilders know how they tend to follow mainstream dietary guidelines that these types of plant-based fats are good, and with all of the protein that bodybuilders consume, regardless of how lean it is, they're still getting a lot of fat and a large dose of linoleic acid when they eat like conventionally raised chicken. So we've established that the majority of people now, bodybuilders included, are consuming unnatural amounts of linoleic acid. Not to be confused with alpha-linolenic acid, which is another omega-6, which isn't nearly as inflammatory, you know, it doesn't kill people. You are what you eat. So the fatty acid profile of the foods you eat, the amount of saturated fats, omega-3s, omega-6s, will translate to the fat profile of all the cells in your body. This takes years and years and years to change and accumulate, but eventually, if the percentage of linoleic acid in your tissue gets high enough, as a result of a diet high in linoleic acid, your body starts recognizing those cells as invaders and attacks them with macrophages, white blood cells. There are many inflammatory syndromes and diseases that can be correlated to this high amount of linoleic acid in cells. The specific action with heart disease occurs with cholesterol molecules. Normally, cholesterol is traveling between the blood vessels in the heart to deliver nutrients. So, you know, in the arterial wall of the heart, where those blockages happen, cholesterol is normally traveling there. So, you know, if that cholesterol is going in and out of the vessels as a normal biological function, and it becomes inflamed from linoleic acid and the body attacks it, you know, imagine you have an inflamed mass of cholesterol being attacked by macrophages in the middle of the blood vessel. You know, that's what the blockage essentially is. Your body tries to clear the inflammation, but if the factors in your lifestyle promote the oxidation of that linoleic acid, it will build up faster than you can clear it. Smoking, environmental toxins, stress, diabetes, metabolic syndromes, all of these can result in an increased buildup of plaque and impaired immune function to remove it. So the plaque ends up getting bigger and bigger and bigger, eventually bursting, causing a blockage known as a heart attack. And without linoleic acid present in high amounts, this cannot happen. So John is technically right about egg yolks being bad because conventional factory farmed eggs are high in linoleic acid as a result of the chickens being fed predominantly corn and soy, which, you know, contain a high percentage of linoleic acid. That being said, blaming eggs when you have nut butters, seeds, vegetable oils in your diet is very silly. You could eat all the crappy eggs you want and you'd probably never get a heart attack. It's the compounding of all of those negative foods and lifestyle factors. The second cause of a heart attack, which John touched on, is calcification. Your body deposits calcium in the arteries, which causes them to harden and restrict blood flow. It's a very simple and preventable problem. The main reason is lack of vitamins D3 and K2, which are necessary for proper calcium metabolism. If you don't have vitamin D3, calcium cannot mobilize. If you don't have vitamin K2, calcium cannot be stored in the proper places. A secondary reason is excess calcium in the diet itself. So, you know, combination of vitamin D3 deficiency, vitamin K2 deficiency, and excess calcium results in calcification. Unfortunately, standard American diet is a perfect storm of those three things. The mechanism is very complicated, and if you guys want to listen to the full explanation, you can check out my calcification video. The simple version of that is the soft tissue in your heart starts behaving like bone tissue in the absence of these vitamins with large amounts of calcium, and it starts depositing calcium in the same way osteoblasts and osteoclasts do so in bone tissue. But this can also be prevented and reversed, just like avoiding linoleic acid can prevent and reverse that poor fatty acid ratio and inflammation in the arterial lining. That's a fairly obvious one. Optimize the omega ratios in your diet. Consume your fat calories from high quality sources. You know, make sure naturally raised animal foods comprise all of that fat macronutrient. Just by eating organic grass-fed beef instead of grain-fed, using raw butter instead of margarine or vegetable oil, buying eggs from a local farm as opposed to the supermarket, incorporating wild-caught fish or a good source of omega-3 a few times a month, all of these things will optimize the fatty acid ratios in your diet, and over the course of several years, will restore your cells to a healthy state. For calcification, you could technically do it naturally. Vitamin D3 is, you know, obviously from the sun, vitamin K2 is synthesized by a healthy gut, and calcium isn't an issue in excess with adequate magnesium present. Problem is, no one really gets this correct naturally, no one gets enough sun, people don't have healthy guts, and they certainly aren't getting enough magnesium because of soil depletion. Vitamin D3 can be supplemented, vitamin K2 specifically in the form MK4 can be supplemented, and calcium can be reduced. Magnesium can be supplemented. When you get these nutrients in the proper ratios, calcium buildup will be prevented, and if you already have calcification, it will be reversed over the course of several years. That being said, you know, plenty of people take vitamin D3 without the K2, which is just as important. So definitely check out my video on each of those vitamins that I've done in the past, especially the one on, you know, why you need vitamin K2, MK4. One other consideration is the massive amount of calcium and vitamin A these bodybuilders might be consuming unintentionally. You know, they have to eat a lot of calories to build up muscle, and this can throw off nutrient synergy fairly easily. And the problem isn't really that they're consuming all of this calcium from whey protein. Whey protein is very high in calcium, and a lot of the other supplements are fortified with calcium as a preservative. or you know they're eating a lot of excess retinol from egg yolks. It's that these bodybuilders aren't getting those synergistic nutrients that work with them. The ones we just mentioned, vitamin D3, vitamin K2, magnesium. You know, plus, when you consume a large volume of food, you're more prone to the negatives of a food being grown. You know, if you're downing glyphosate sprayed rice and atrazine injected beef in incredibly large amounts, you're eating multiple times more poison than the average person. So as a bodybuilder or anyone who has to eat a lot of calories for performance, it's incredibly important to go organic with everything. You know, buy your meats and animal products locally from a farm, raised without agrochemicals, antibiotics, anything negative, in order to prevent the accumulation of toxins that can contribute to issues like heart disease by impairing detox pathways and you know, a whole bunch of other metabolic mechanisms. So thank you guys for joining me. Hopefully John sees this or someone sees this and lets him know how he can prevent this issue from happening in the future by optimizing the fatty acid ratios in his diet. And there might be a couple of other things he has to address. So definitely drop a like, leave me a comment below, boys. It's 4:45 in the morning, and I haven't slept in 2 days. The least you guys could do is subscribe so that YouTube can unsubscribe you next week. So I'll see you guys for tomorrow's video, of course, as usual. And the next live stream will be on Thursday.